Excel has a number of different lookup functions. We'll be talking specifically about the VLOOKUP function, the HLOOKUP function, also match, index, and a few others. What a lot of them have in common is the need to refer to external data, sometimes referred to as a table array. Without getting into the details of those specific functions that I mentioned, notice on this worksheet called Lookups, we see two lists with yellow backgrounds, and they contain the same data. Which is easier to read? Nearly everybody, when confronted with that question, would say the list in columns G and H is easier to read than the horizontal list at the top here in rows 1 and 2. As we'll see later, using the functions VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP, either one of those functions can provide us with the information that we need based on the context of looking up, for example, a tax rate. But the way we lay out data on the screen is important, and invariably, if you have to use this kind of data, the vertical list is preferred by most people, easier to read. A lot of tables that we use in the different formulas are either two columns, as we see over in columns G and H, or two rows, like we saw above earlier. Sometimes you'll see a list like this. The whole idea behind lookup functions is based on what we see along the top or left side of a list. We're going to pull out other related information off to the right or below. And sometimes those lists are more complex, more involved. At other times, you might be comparing lists, and these are just portions of what could be much, much larger lists, two different lists in different locations, all based on the idea that they've got something in common. Maybe in the list on the right, we're trying to get the salary out of the other list. What do the two lists have in common? Social Security numbers. So without getting into the specifics of the different functions, just talking about the general idea here of how we lay out data, how we structure data. If there's any situation where you're designing a list, make it vertical rather than horizontal, it tends to work better. And in the list over here that we just saw, this almost by definition inherently is going to be a vertical list. This information here would not make much sense if we structured it horizontally. So the various kinds of layouts that we see within Excel will vary somewhat. The other thing we want to talk about too before actually getting started with the functions is this idea that sometimes when you use a lookup function, you're looking for data exactly. For example, someone's name, someone's ID number. At other times in a table like this, you're simply looking for a breakpoint. If we ultimately are trying to get to a tax rate here based on these salaries, we don't see the exact salaries in this list. If we talk about an approximate match, keep in mind there's that kind of a lookup too. Sometimes, just like when you're doing your own taxes, for example, you're looking at those breakpoints. Is the adjusted salary at this level? What does that mean in terms of the rate here? Or we could do it on the horizontal table as well too. So a variety of different considerations here before we actually begin using some of the lookup functions. And in most cases, if you're trying to pull related data in by using lookup functions, it's best if you can have all the data on the same worksheet. Now, you can't always do that. Sometimes it makes good sense to have data on different worksheets and to keep the data there. But when you're trying to set up these functions, it's going to be easier if they happen to be on the same sheet. So I've seen a number of different layout possibilities before we actually start using the functions VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, match, index, and a few others. We're about to use either the VLOOKUP or the HLOOKUP function in its form called approximate match. So we're about to take these salaries in column C and return the tax rate based on the information that we're seeing either in this vertical table here in columns G and H or in the horizontal table we see to the right up in rows 2 and 3 starting in column J. Both of these lists have the same information in them. I think it's apparent to most people this list here is easier to read. It's not just because it's closer to the data, by the way, but just the way it's structured. We don't have to scroll back and forth. Whenever you're setting up a list like this, give it some thought. Most of the time, a vertical table fits better on the Excel screen. Therefore, we will be using the VLOOKUP function much more often than we will the HLOOKUP function. V for vertical, H for horizontal. And the way both of these functions work is, in the example that we're seeing here, the salary, the first salary, $64,000, ultimately will allow us to return not 3.5%, but 3%. The logic of how VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP work is not to find the next highest value, but to revert to the value just below this entry here. And that 63,900, although closer to 65,000, is actually going to be focused on the 55,000 number. We're going to be getting 3%. Let's use this with VLOOKUP. VLOOKUP, as we're using it here for an approximate match, has three arguments to it, three parameters, as some people call them. We're looking up this value, C2, comma. A table array refers to this list right here, comma. And now we indicate the column. And it's not column H, although literally it is. We put in the number 2. Reading from left to right, column G is the first column, column H is the second column. And we get our answer of 3%. That happened to be formatted earlier. If it were not, it might look like this, using the comma button, but you can click the percent button. Before copying this down the column, we need to make sure this reference here stays constant, becomes an absolute reference. We'll highlight it. Press the function key F4. I'll press Control Enter here to complete the entry and prevent it from moving down into the next cell. Double-click the lower right-hand corner. All these appear to be correct. It's important in lists like this, when you're using VLOOKUP as an approximate match, that these be in ascending order. They don't have to be equally spaced. We must cover the lowest rate. Of course, no salary would be below zero, so that's automatically covered. If there were a salary in the list that were $150,000, $180,000, something like that, it would revert to the highest number that we see in the list here, 7.5%. If these are not in ascending order, you still might get a lot of believable and correct answers. I'm going to change the 35,000 right here to be 85,000. As I press Enter, keep an eye on column D. Some of those rates will change, but a lot of them didn't. And you can imagine in certain situations, you're checking a list, you say, oh, that one's right, okay, that one's right. But you could overlook the fact that some of these might not be. Always give this a quick look. For an approximate match VLOOKUP and for HLOOKUP, these need to be in ascending order. And we're talking, of course, if we were using an HLOOKUP, we're talking about the left to right order of the top row of that list. If we were locked into using HLOOKUP because of existing formulas on a worksheet that we didn't want to disrupt, maybe we have to use that other horizontal list, this would be HLOOKUP. Obviously, the location of the table would be different, but the two would stay the same if this were an HLOOKUP. It would refer to the second row of the table, that row over there that has the percents in it. Now, another adjustment we could make here makes it a little bit simpler. Instead of using this, which certainly is not wrong, if you drag across columns G and H and then copy this down the column, this will work as well. It's certainly less cluttered looking. And the only caveat there is make sure no other information ever goes into columns G and H. So that will give us the same answer. I'll drag across just a few of these, temporarily make this column a lot wider, and expose the formulas. We can do this with the keystroke shortcut Control Tilde, and we'll see the difference in the two sets there. And I think it's clearer, too, as to what really is happening. I'll press Control Tilde again to go back to a normal view. So we've seen how to use the VLOOKUP function for an approximate match kind of a scenario here. And although we could have used HLOOKUP, we strongly recommend VLOOKUP in most cases, particularly because the table is much easier to read. And of course, in both situations, it's always easier to work with these functions if the table data, the table lookup array, is on the same sheet. We want to calculate a numerical score for those ratings in column E. And there's a table over in columns A and B. And already VLOOKUP is set up here, but it's not working properly. It's in cell F2. As I double-click here, look what we're trying to do. We're trying to find the word fair using VLOOKUP. By definition, VLOOKUP will compare that entry with the entries over in column A. And when it finds a match, we want to get data out of the second column of that table. 2 refers to the second column in that table in columns A and B. And of course, that means out of column B. So why are we getting an answer here that's wrong? 50 is not the correct answer. Anytime you use VLOOKUP for an exact match, you need a fourth argument. And I'd never call that intuitive or obvious. Following the 2, we put in a comma and watch what pops up on the screen. If we want exact match, we use false. I'll double click it. You can tab it into place. You can type it. There it is. And now we will get a correct answer here of 71. And simply copy this down the column by double clicking the lower right hand corner. All of these other entries are correct. Now, as an alternate, but hardly much better in terms of meaning, we can use 0. I use zero for a couple of reasons. It's less typing. Doesn't false seem to suggest something failed maybe or didn't work? And a third reason, not so obvious at first, is the companion function we'll see in a bit, called match, also uses zero for exact match. So you have to use either false or zero, and by the way, even a third argument, simply put in a comma with nothing behind it. I prefer to use the zero to bring it out a bit more strongly, but this works as well too. And we can copy that down the column if we wish with double-clicking. You get correct answers in all these cases too. Now, when you're working with larger lists, sometimes on different worksheets, you'll have to be using this same kind of construction. Next worksheet over is called Large Table VLOOKUPs. You can imagine these two lists being in different files, maybe different worksheets. What we're trying to do, and this is quite common, we want to pull data together based on a common field. Let's say this list on the right, we want it to grow by picking up the salary from the other list over on the left side. And we'd be using Social Security number as a common entry. Be a little bit careful with Social Security numbers because sometimes they have actual dashes in them. In column G, as I'm clicking these, look in the formula bar, the dashes are actually there. Over in column A, we don't see any dashes. What's the difference? Column A has been formatted. There is a special format. I'll right-click column A, jump right into format cells. On the number tab, special Social Security number. Think of these as somewhat like dollar signs, which most of the time we don't type. We simply apply a format that shows them. So with Social Security numbers, particularly when you're setting these up, use this format. You won't have to type the dashes, but you'll see them in the layout. But it's a source of a lot of mismatched VLOOKUPs when you don't have consistency in the two lists. So I'm going to make column E narrower, and I'll use VLOOKUP right here in cell J2. Remember, the purpose here is to return the salary out of the other list based on looking up a Social Security number. So this is a bit more involved than our previous example. Equal VLOOKUP. Left parenthesis, we're looking up this Social Security number, comma, where are we looking? We're looking over in columns A, but we want that salary, so A, B, and C. Just drag across the column letters like that, comma. We want to get data out of the third column, reading from left to right, that's column C. So we put in the 3, comma, we want this to be an exact match. False or zero, there we are. And it doesn't work, and of course, it's because of the dashes. If we try this on a few more cells, same thing's going to happen. A quick fix will be here, click column G on the Home tab, find and select. Replace all those dashes with nothing. Dash here, nothing, replace all. Look at column J out there as I close this dialog box. As a follow-up here, right-click format cells, quick way to get there, to make them be consistent in appearance. Not truly necessary here, but that would be a logical thing to do. Special, Social Security number, okay. So now we have a match. This would work all the way down the column. We're using VLOOKUP here to compare information and pull together information based on a common field in different layouts here. This is a bit trickier to do when it's on separate sheets or separate workbooks, but you can do it there too. And once again, VLOOKUP quickly gives us the exact match that we need. The example here, based on Social Security number.